Hi, Matt Williams, Technovangelist here. Wow, these RAVPower videos have been popular. And so many comments. It's awesome. I love it. Well, there have been a few questions about networking. I can understand not getting this stuff if networking wasn't something you did for a long time at work. I'm going to talk about connecting a tablet to the internet and getting access to your hard drive as well. I'm using an iPad, but the process is similar no matter what device you're using. If you like videos like this, consider hitting that subscribe button below. If you have any experience with the device, share them with everyone in the comment section. So you just got a RAVPower FileHub or some other travel router, and you want to connect your tablet to that and get access to the drive connected to it and connect to the internet. But your tablet can only connect to a single network. How would this work? Well, the FileHub or whatever travel router you're using acts as a kind of bridge between you and your network. Everything connected to the FileHub, like a drive or SD card, is sitting on that bridge. And right now, it's your home network, but you could take this into a cafe and want to connect to your cafe's network. So let's connect to the FileHub's network. If you haven't changed the name of it, it should be something like RAV-FileHub- and then a 2G or 5G. If you're on the older FileHub Plus, you won't see the 5G network. Now, 5G is significantly faster, and I think worth the upgrade, if you're wondering. Now, if you have the newer FileHub, the WD-007, and you aren't seeing the 5G network, it's possible that it's not turned on. On the side of the device, to the left of the SD card, is a button with a Wi-Fi icon on it. Press that for 3 seconds, and it will switch from supporting 2.4G only to 5G only. Press it for 3 seconds again, and it switches to supporting 2.4G and 5G. Now that's probably what you want, unless you know you want one of the other options. So now connect your phone or tablet or computer to the 5G network. If you haven't changed anything, the password is 8 ones. 11111111. Now open your FileHub app. I'll use the web page since it fits better on the screen. To get there, type 10.10.10.254 into your browser's location bar. The default password, if you haven't changed anything, is nothing. There is no password. So here we are. All the settings can be found in the settings section. If you're on your iOS device using the newer FileHub app, you'll see a gear at the top right. On the older FileHub Plus app, it's the system icon. And on Android, well, it'll be something similar. So here, go to Internet Settings, and it'll start searching for a network. Pick your home network from the list and enter your password. Now, if you don't see anything showing up here, there's a little trick to get it working. Remember I said that unless you know what you're doing, you should select the 2.4G and 5G option? Well, this is why. If you want to connect to the FileHub and connect to the internet at the same time, and you want to do it all wirelessly, then you have to connect to your home Wi-Fi with a 2.4 gigahertz connection. Yes, this is a bit confusing. If you want everything to be on the faster connection and you want to access the internet, then you need to connect to your network using a wired connection. There is no way around this. If you're just using the FileHub to get access to drives, then 5G is going to work perfectly fine. And now you're set. Go through the rest of the options and play around with all of them. There's nothing you can do to break the device. If you get to a point where you can't do anything because you've set something wrong, there's a little reset button right here next to the Ethernet jack. That's the hole that looks like a bigger phone cable jack. Some of the options I recommend you change are the password for accessing the configuration screen and the Wi-Fi password. Now, if you find this video helpful, consider subscribing to the channel right here. If you have any other questions, let me know in the comments. As you can see, I've been making some of these questions into videos. And check out some of the other videos that I think you might find interesting. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.